Welcome to another Tutor Short provided by the Educational Support Services Department of Lehigh Carbon Community College in Snecksville, Pennsylvania, which is just outside of Allentown. These videos review key learnings for the science courses provided here at LCC. And please remember that the Educational Support Services Department does provide walk-in tutoring 5 days a week.
Okay, so this is an overview of how a muscle contracts. So we'll begin right here with the axon terminal. So we have the acetylcholine-filled vesicles that travel to the presynaptic membrane, and they fuse right here on this membrane, and they release acetylcholine through exocytosis. The acetylcholine travels across the synaptic cleft, and they bind to chemically gated channels. And so the action potential gets propagated across the sarcolemma and reaches a structure called the T-tubule. The T-tubule is basically just like an extension of the sarcolemma. The T-tubule continues to have sodium-potassium voltage-gated channels. And so the action potential goes through the T-tubule and gets to a structure called the triad. The triad consists of two sarcoplasmic reticulums and the T-tubule right in the middle. So as the action potential makes its way through the T-tubule, calcium is released from the terminal cisternae of the sarcoplasmic reticulum right here. Okay, so I also do want to mention that there are calcium channels not only on the terminal cisternae of the sarcoplasmic reticulum, but all along the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Those calcium channels along the sarcoplasmic reticulum are found right over here. And there are also, like I said before, calcium channels on the terminal cisternae of the sarcoplasmic reticulum, which they're going to be found right over here. And so calcium is then released from these channels into the sarcoplasm.
Okay, so this is showing a close-up of the last picture. We have the T-tubule, we have the sarcoplasmic reticulum, and the two terminal cisternae on either side of the T-tubule. You can see the calciums inside of the terminal cisternae. I also want you to know that there are calciums that will come out kind of everywhere. As Joe pointed out earlier, that there are calcium channels all along sarcoplasmic reticulum. Once the calcium exits the sarcoplasmic reticulum, it is freely bouncing around inside the sarcoplasm of the cell, and it will, until it comes in contact with the thin filament, which you can see in blue over here. These are the thin filaments known as actin. And we have our thick filaments known as myosin, with the myosin heads coming up. All right, and next we're going to go into a little more detail about actin and myosin and their role in muscle contraction.